for that.
Wait a minute,
check.
What just happened? Hold on a second. Oh, God. I don't know what just happened for my TV. Man. That's a part of this. All right. The motherfucker just went down. Check one two. Burr House Show is definitely in effect. On this wonderful Friday night, January 6th, 2023. Happy New Year, everybody.
Happy New Year, everybody. Yes. Happy New Year, everyone.
There it is. News down there somewhere. Yo, new outlook, you know what I'm saying? Yo, Miss The Latina Marie.
Yes, The Latina Marie.
You just got you a new crib, you know what I'm saying? You starting your, you know what I'm saying, new environment, right?
Yes, I'm trying to.
How's it coming along?
It's coming along, getting used to the sounds in the area.
How is the area?
Ask me that this summer.
Gotcha.
Yeah, when I've been there a whole summer.
Gotcha. Well, I'm glad, you know what I'm saying? I'm hoping to do the same thing soon, but I'm going to try to see if I can put my ducks in a row. I think that's the way to say it, right?
Most definitely.
Yeah. You know, I've been trying to keep these kids right. I got one getting ready to graduate. You know what I'm saying? I got one that's out here in the work world right now. You know what I'm saying? He just got his, finished his driving school, got a certificate.
Right.
So, you know, I'm about to go ahead on and we going to get our stuff together tomorrow, make sure he got his insurance and stuff.
So it's temps or he got his license?
Well, he got his driving school certificate.
Oh, yeah, I forgot about
so
driving
now
school.
He has his temps. Now he about to schedule for his actual
driver test.
Yep.
Gotcha.
Yep. And mind you, when you first turn 16, nowadays, you got to wait 6 months before they allow you to get your driver's license.
And don't you have to have so many hours also with driving with your parents or your
mm-hmm.
family?
That's what the driving school was for, that he paid for out of his pocket.
Yeah, how much is driving school?
$400.
Okay.
And he paid for it out of his pocket. And his birthday was in May, so
right.
he ain't fucking around.
I see, he on it.
That boy ain't skipped a step, you know what I'm saying?
So do you remember when we used to take drivers at in school, it was like $150?
I remember when it was available. I didn't take it. I know Big Germ did.
Oh yeah, I did too.
Yeah, he was telling me he took it at Marshall, I think.
Yeah.
I said his name before. Was it the track teacher? The track coach?
Mr. Elkins was not a driver's ed coach.
Okay.
He was just track and Spanish.
Gotcha. Okay.
It was a Caucasian dude or a Greek dude, but with no accent.
Okay, with no accent. Gotcha. Okay. Please, the gringo. Gotcha.
I'm not with you today. I'm trying to get less hell points.
Yo, check this out. So, last week we were talking about the Candyman. Probably haven't chance to had the courage to get to that one yet, have you?
No, I haven't even had time to really get to it, personally speaking. I've been trying to get some of these things that I had on my
playlist.
Not just my playlist, but on my schedule for doing my life and doing my own personal dreams in radio, TV, and all that stuff. So that's what I've been trying.
Oh, you know what? You just I was thinking about you earlier, and I wanted to give you. Wanted to do a few minutes. To give us some teaser topics on.
On what's going on?
Yeah, let me know. Let's say once again what the name of the show is again.
It's my beginning show. It's called Tongue in Cheek.
Tongue in Cheek.
Yes, it's a podcast that discusses all issues. And sometimes I get a little bit of racy, but we do bring the funny too. You know, I bring the funny. Our topic that I will be discussing, that one, because I put topics on my Facebook and my Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
And I'll let people vote for them, or you say which one you'd like to know about. But the topic that one for the new year is my coin phrase that I started called Starter Girlfriends.
Starter Girlfriend.
Yes, Starter Girlfriend.
I'd like you to elaborate on that.
A Starter Girlfriend. A Starter Girlfriend is a girl who teaches you how to do everything she wants you to do with her, but you won't do it, and you take it and run and go do it with the next bitch, or the next chick, I'm sorry, the next chick.
Interesting.
Because she'll beg and plead and scream and holler and break her neck, back, and shoulders for you to do simple stuff, like a walk in the park holding hands, picnic, free things. And you won't do it with her, but you'll run out with the next chick, and you'll go do it with her.
That sounds like an interesting topic.
Oh, yeah, most definitely. So please, if y'all got questions, comments, put them in the inbox, put them in the comments.
And let them know where to find you, where to follow you at.
I am on all podcast streams, starting from Anchor and everyone that they go through, even Google Podcasts, Spotify. I'm on all of them. I am also on Facebook at Latania Campbell, Facebook, and I am the Latania Marie on Instagram.
And there it is.
There it is.
And there it is.
Period, boo.
So, you know, this new year, let's see how we're going to start this year out before we hit the entertainment thing. First off, you know that the minimum wage has officially been raised in Ohio.
To what?
10-10.
Okay, well, I've never made minimum wage.
Yeah, well, for those of us that have, I remember the days when I wished, matter of fact, some of the managers weren't even making that much money in certain sectors of the industries, you know what I'm saying? So I'm trying to tell my kids, they don't realize how they have it, because they be having jobs where off top they'd be like $14.50 an hour,
right.
You know what I'm saying? And I'd be like, bruh. And they'd be tripping. They'd be like, that ain't, you know what I'm saying? And I'd be like, man, y'all tripping, man. I wish we would have was making that kind of money back in our days, you know what I'm saying?
Definitely, because like I said, I never really worked a job that paid minimum wage,
mm-hmm.
because I've always been in a trade school type of facility, so I've always bracket my price or made $14-$15 out the rest.
Lucky man, I wish I had it like you.
No, I wish
I'm gonna be like you when I grow up.
I'm not growing up yet, I'm still
juvenile. Yo, so check this out, we got another law thing. You know, I'm not big on the politics, but I want to share with you. Michael DeWine signed a new law in the state of Ohio. So if you are seen with a cell phone in your hand, that is now a primary offense.
Yeah, I heard about that, and they'll be writing tickets now, so everybody needs to get a cell phone bracket.
Absolutely. So, and let me clarify what the difference is. Okay, so you know the city of Brooklyn started that law.
Right. No talking and driving, no texting and driving.
All
right,
but when it started it and it spread across the rest of the cities and counties and stuff across the state of Ohio, it was not a primary offense. So like if you, like they couldn't pull you over unless you had some other offense, like, you know.
Other offense or suspicion of to lead on to not just
the food. Right, but not anymore. And they said it don't make no difference if you, what was it, using the GPS, talking on the speakerphone, none of that. If they see it like while it's in your hand, that's a primary offense. And they can pull you over for it.
So if the only way you can't get a ticket is if your car is parked, is off. And you're talking on the phone, will they still give you a ticket?
I don't know, man, because I'm not really clear on exactly what's okay and what's not okay, because you got Lyft drivers who got their phone like in a little cradle thing, and sometimes they got to kind of change, you feel me? So I don't know, but if I don't know, I'm pretty sure every cop in the state of Ohio don't know too.
They don't care.
Sometimes they be overstepping their bounds, thinking that that's what they was, what I'm saying, in their jurisdiction, and it don't be.
Exactly, and that's what I'm curious. Like, say I'm getting out my car, say I'm pulled over, car off, or even car running, but I'm talking on my phone. What are you gonna do?
And the thing about it is the reason why I'm sharing this with our friends is because, what does they say? Ignorance is not an excuse for the law.
It isn't.
So if you did not know, you still be held accountable just as well.
You know what I'm saying? And knowing is half the battle. So now you guys know. Make sure that you follow up, do your research into it. Make sure that you're gonna not be caught out here like that, because this right here is gonna be even worse than the traffic stopping light. Picture camera.
Mm-hmm.
This is gonna be worse than that.
So there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. That's our little legal tidbit for you for the week. You know what I'm saying? But I also wanted to talk about two things real quick. Talk about basketball. I'm gonna keep this brief, okay? I was watching a YouTube documentary this morning about Kyrie Irving and his game in the league lately since, they're trying to cancel him, I guess, for, you know what I'm saying, promoting the movie, mm-hmm. Hebrews to Negroes. He's been sitting on everybody in the league. If you did not know, Kyrie Irving is a monster out here, sitting on them. Man, I'm telling you, Kyrie Irving, it's like he playing to kind of like prove a point, like not necessarily prove a point, but
to show he matters and it's right. Like, how can you be so mad because we are included in something?
Ball. That's it. It's motivating, man.
Exactly.
And another thing. So while we're talking about basketball, I just wanted to give a quick mention to the Cleveland Cavaliers, who are just snapping out of a losing streak, but they played against the Chicago Bulls on Monday. And I have to mention this. The boy, Donovan Mitchell, beasted, all right? Franchise record that he broke. All-time franchise Cleveland Cavaliers record. This boy hit for 71 points in one game. But, and we won. We were down by 18 points like the whole game.
Okay.
So he just kicked in gear, like, you feel me? And then guess what the league did to him?
What did they do?
Well, after he scored 71 points, they hit him with a drug test for performance enhancing drugs, which he didn't
have. But they got to make sure he's not breaking no new records.
Come on, man. They didn't do that to my nigga Kobe when he hit the 80. What was it, 82?
But, you know,
what's that? I forgot the other dude named Dučić. I forgot his name. Yeah, it's, man, well.
Kobe, you know, was a different thing, though, because, you know, Kobe was basically like the choir boy. He did regular things versus the enhancement things.
The Black Mamba.
Right, I miss him so much.
Man, speaking about missing folks, I think we need to mention one of our loved ones in our community. You want to help me out?
We're going to take this time, after we say a few things about this beautiful queen, and get a few moments of silence. We just lost one of our good girls, good queens, Latasha Spraggins, part of the Spraggins family from the west side of Cleveland. She passed away just before or on the New Year's, and I have to say, this is one of my good girlfriends when we were little growing up, staying the night at each other's houses and stuff. I call her uncles, my uncles, her granny, my granny. And, you know, even though through time we've spread apart and lived our own lives, every time we run into each other, it's, hey, girl, hey. You know, so I'm really going to miss my friend. Mm-hmm. And I just want to tell the family that we are all here for you, so reach out to us. And we love you, and this is such a terrible loss.
Yes, it is. And also, I just wanted to mention, I had DJed her 18th birthday party, off in the hood, you know what I'm saying?
Right.
And it just touches you, it hits home.
It really does, because it's like you're just seeing them posting on Facebook 2 days, 3 days ago, and then you see somebody in their family posting that, yo, this, that, and the other, and it's like, damn, like, for real, like, I don't want to lose nobody else, nobody. No, can we wait a little bit longer, because this is just too hard, it's too much, you know, and I'm so sorry for her kids, the uncles, the mothers, you know, cousins. I'm so sorry for you guys, I really am. And my prayers are with you that you can get through this.
Trying to get this thing to pull up before I can add it to our
little
collective here. Yeah, this second mind is doing what it wants to do.
But we'll get it up there before the
ending
of the conversation.
I know what to do. And we'll get it up there. Just bear with me for a minute. Until then, we're going to just issue out a short moment of silence. And we're back. You rest up. 49 years old. Alright, well, I'm having a good time though. I'm trying to make my adjustments to, you know, I made a few changes in my personal life, you know what I'm saying?
What are those changes, if you don't mind telling us?
I'm learning something new. I'm going through a career change. And so I got into a field in which I always try to tell myself I didn't want to get into that field. Mm-hmm. But I wanted to do something different. And I wanted something that was, like, I felt like it was, like kind of like where it was meaningful.
Right.
So kind of following behind my little brother, Bobby, though, Voice of the Young People. Shout out to him. He's at work right now. But after watching him for a few months, you know, he encouraged me to apply. He was like, you know, you're smarter than me, and I think you would probably make it here. You know, he was just telling me, like, you know, I was like, but I don't know, Bob. I think they might be kind of like, you know, I don't want to do nothing bad. Like, you know what I'm saying? I want to be good. If I do something, I want to be good at it.
Right.
So I was apprehensive. I was apprehensive because of the, you know, the level of quality, you know what I'm saying, and the prestige, like the name alone of this particular company. You know what I'm saying? I didn't want to come into it and then, you know, not be able to adjust well.
Right.
But they've been willing to, you know, train and work with me and all of that stuff. So I just take it one day at a time. But I know that I put God first in everything that I'm doing these days, you know, and that, and when I do that, I'm not even worried about the outcome. It's like, it just kind of like just raises the bar on just, not so much as just confidence, but just your own security.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? You can walk with your head high, you can afford to pay your rent, you know what I'm saying? And you're not doing something where you feel like less than a dinner,
Exactly. You don't feel like you have to sell a piece of your soul to get a little piece of change or a piece of whatever.
Right, so I can live with that. Give me 2 seconds. This is Bobby Doe, Voice of the Young People. Bobby Doe, what up? You on the air?
Whatever.
You got it. We just gave you a shout out, bro.
Oh,
Most definitely.
Well, that's what's up. How you going? When you going to try to get with him? All right, well, let me know, because, you know, we got a date.
Yeah, I know, and I'm definitely on that shit. I ain't got nothing going on tomorrow. I'm gonna help with Janet, but, I mean, she's saying my thing, too, so now I gotta help you, so go for it.
Is she going, where is it, are you supposed to meet up with the dude somewhere?
He's off, like, dancing the store, so I can probably go over there. She'll give me a ride, though.
All right, well, cool. I'm gonna hit you up when I'm repping the show up. I'm on live if you can get to it. Probably on YouTube or something.
All right, the ass game's on until we get off.
Oh, bet. Good looking.
All right.
Peace. Yep, gotta show love, man. You know what I'm saying? Because we're thinning out. We're thinning out, man. You know what I'm saying? And we're crossing that threshold. My dad, I want to shout out to my dad. He went to Georgia this week, so he'll be back hopefully next week sometime. The last time that he left town, he went to Florida. Not Miami, but Florida.
Mm-hmm.
And while he was in Orlando, Florida, but he was there while the hurricane was there. So my dad is now actually a hurricane survivor.
Wow.
And he also recently, he's a stroke survivor, too. So I keep my tabs on my old man. You know what I'm saying? That's my dog out there. So, you know, I'll be looking forward to those conversations when he can make it back.
Right.
I wish we'd be able to watch the Browns game together, but I already told you what I'm gonna do. Didn't I?
Most definitely.
What did I tell you I was gonna do?
He's gonna invest in little DraftKings, guys, and put it all on the ground.
FanDuel, I'm putting it all. Hey. And everybody I know is telling me not to do it.
I said put
But everybody I know is a Steelers fan, and I'm like, fuck them all. I'm gonna do it just to spite. And I don't care if I lose.
Right.
It's not my first rodeo. I'm a Browns fan.
It's just
we do it all the time.
Gamble in Cleveland.
Exactly. I want to participate. I want to partake.
I'll be glad when, if they're not legalizing gambling, they need to legalize flour.
Oh, yeah. And
it's,
you know what?
It's time to legalize the flour.
Did you peep out that New York just opened up their first dispensary?
Yes, a legal, not a recreational one.
Yeah.
Yes.
Wait a minute. It's recreational, right?
It's recreational. Legal recreational.
That just sounds wonderful, don't it?
Doesn't it?
Don't it sound wonderful?
All day long.
And they had interviewed the first dude that came out of the store as a customer. Do you know that was a brother?
I bet it was. His cataract was acting up.
Shit, I wish I could get some kind of endeavor popping off like that. I don't know how to grow shit. I could get the plant to come out, but I can't never get that shit to bud. And I have tried and tried.
You can't make no flour.
Nope. I can't, I'm doing something wrong. Hey, look, I'm gonna tell you what I did. I split the seed, I did that. You know what I'm talking about? I changed it from where it was on a wet napkin to I did that. Like, you know what I'm saying? But once it gets to, like, you know, maybe like this tall or so, I'm lost.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
Is that approved? They had long ones off, little long leaves. And then if you see seeds on it, trash it. It's a male plant. You have to be careful because the seeds you get, some
are
male,
some are
female,
so
just trying to get a handful of seeds.
Shit,
your life
would
just be
male. And I've had them. And they turn yellow. And the stalk gets skinny. And, you
how
know,
much summer are you giving them? You know you have to have 12 hours.
I don't know, man.
Right.
I don't know. I think I tried to run I think I tried to run like a light timer in a closet before. And then I tried to. I wasn't doing this shit right, man.
The first set I've grew way back, like when we had that blackout.
Yeah.
That's how far back it was.
I remember the blackout, too.
I had just had some seeds and I threw them in this big old flower pot I had. 6 foot seeds. You know, the seeds grew 6 foot plants, but they were all males. But it still grew big part of
And I've seen a lot of people with plants before that were tall, but they were all males.
Yeah. Usually they're males. It's hard. You have to make sure you're getting the right seeds.
And is this something you're supposed to do? Like, you got to keep them, like, distant from each other? Like, can't you make a male a female or some shit like that?
Not exactly sure, but you shouldn't put more than one plant per pot.
Right, but it's like a square footage thing, I think, because they'll cross-germinate. But sometimes that could be bad, though, right?
Yes.
Matter of fact, no. It turns a female to a male is what it does.
Yes.
Man, you know what? I wanna do some research. Cause why not?
Mm-hmm. Pull you out some stuff.
Why not? I mean,
they're gonna be looking for grow houses here soon if you can get in. They have a couple of classes.
You know, I always thought that. You know, I remember a few years ago, you started seeing all these little greenhouses popping up, these little, like, urban. I always thought that somebody that kind of knew what they was doing was already just kind of setting it up, anticipating that this was going to be.
Well, the thing is, though, they had a few people out here. I think it's only, like, about 3 to 4 major people who are allowed to grow out here in Australia.
That's why that shit keep getting voted down, though, because they keep trying to monopolize everything.
It's about time they just let it go. I'm done, like, dude, we're tired of traveling to Detroit. We're tired of having calls.
I remember I went to Detroit, man, and I smoked on the way back, man. I was so paranoid. Hey, look, it's fucked up. I could have swore that the people was following me, trying to wait till I crossed the state line, right? But, you know, they're not following you. There's only one way to go. You know what I'm saying?
Exactly.
But I was high. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Because I had some pre-rolls.
Oh, those are wonderful.
Oh, man.
My favorite pre-roll is by, what is it called? City Republic. And it's called Triangulary.
Man, that shit had me so annoyed.
Look, I ain't never been stuck in a long time. I'm driving back to Detroit, me and my girl. Hey, shout out to Honey Bad. We smoking. She fell asleep. I'm driving back and I'm stuck. Like, Chuck, I'm like, damn, I ain't said shit. Ain't changed the radio. Nothing.
Oh, my God.
So every time I go, I make sure I get me at least 4 of those pre-rolls.
You know what? You just reminded me. See, now you talk, you enabling me. Let me holler at my people. Shout out to my mans. I'm not going to say them. Gunman all over the joint, but you know what time it is.
Yeah.
And anybody else, man, you know, if I owe you a shout out to you, man. I don't want nobody to think that I'd be like ghosting them or nothing like that, man. I'd be grinding. For real, but like, you know what I'm saying? I respect the hustle, man. I respect, you know what I'm saying, the lanes that people pick and stay in and all of that. I try to get people to fuck with me and help me grow, you know what I'm saying? But I don't judge those that, you know, this ain't everybody's cup of tea. But for those that do support me and for those that do take the time to check me out, man, shout out to y'all. Happy New Year. You know what I'm saying? And I'm just glad, you know what I'm saying? Let me know what you're into and give me the opportunity to support you as well. You know what I'm saying? Because we all need support.
Definitely.
Now, what you got going on? What you got planned for the year? What you working on?
I'm trying to work out more.
Work out more? What kind of working out do you do? Walking, biking?
Well, I just put a few more videos up.
Oh, workout videos?
Yes, Nike workout.
For real?
Yeah.
You be trying to hang? You are? That's dope.
Definitely, because, you know, I can't get up to the gym, and I don't really like going to the gym. I do like working out. I'm trying to turn it to the
game. I got you. Maybe I should do the same. But I've been doing this. I've been doing this at work. Every time I change the little piece, I be trying to grab it and curl it a little bit. Cause that bitch got some weight to it. Nah, it's not that much weight,
but it's enough.
I feel like if you do it enough though, and keep that circulation together, cause I can't feel it. You know what I'm saying? I can feel it. So I just do that. But I need to pick up the pace though, man. I'm getting old. I'm getting old. You know what I'm saying? My body ain't healing as fast as it used to. You dig?
Yeah.
But you know, I'm still plugging away though. I pretty much always had pretty good health all my life, so it's not like I'm not really like, you know, worried about anything major. You know what I'm saying? Like not any surprises or anything like that. Nah, man, I'm kinda healthy. I got a few vices, but it's mostly just weed and black and mild for real. You know what I'm saying?
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It's not too bad. I try to take care of myself and be a good like for my kids. I don't want them to see me doing shit and then Right, right. You just, what was that one drug commercial? It was like, I learned it from watching you.
Those old ones. I got it from watching you, Dad.
Yeah.
Like, man, get out of here. You ain't get that shit from me. Man,
I know. Yo, so check it. So I've seen trailers we was talking about. So the BMF started, the first episode started today. It is available on Starz app. And I was able to watch it like before it like aired on cable.
Right.
You know, sometimes they don't let you watch it until it actually airs.
Right.
So I was able to catch up with it before I came here. But also, they showed the new season trailer for the Book of Ghost.
Okay.
With Tariq, that's coming back.
Is it Tariq, or is it going to be somebody else's tale? I thought it was supposed to be somebody else's tale.
No, Tariq is coming back with their new season, and I think in the Power Universe, one of the other souls is going to come back right after that.
Okay.
Probably Tommy.
I think. Is Tommy the right person?
Yeah.
I think that's what it was, too.
Yep. I think his is coming up next. Also, I saw a trailer on Paramount Plus for... This show is so dope. It's called The Mayor of Kingstown. And also, The Mayor of Kingstown is played by Jeremy Renner.
Mm-hmm.
You know, who plays Hawkeye on The Avengers, mm-hmm. you know, Marvel Cinema.
Mm-hmm.
But, you know, he also... Jeremy Renner was just came out of surgery. He had a snowplow accident during the blizzard thing. You know what I'm saying? So he's recovering though. You know what I'm saying? Also, what is the Buffalo Bills player's name that collapsed from cardiac arrest?
He is breathing on his own now.
And talking to his family.
Yes, let's get this young man's name.
After 4 days.
That is a miracle.
After 4 days. And you understand that they said that a cardiac arrest, the road to recovery is not actually anything to do with the heart. It's got something to do with the brain. So it's good that he's talking, because they were like, sometimes people don't really recover.
Right,
as far as cognitive skills, being able to reason and talk. And they removed the breathing tube last night. They said like around midnight. So, you know, he's been breathing on his own since last night. So he's on his way, hopefully, to his road to recovery. And we'll be keeping an eye on that. You know what I mean? And we'll keep you in our prayers. That was one scary incident.
Yeah, that was wild.
Especially for all the mothers out there
who sons want to
play. I know.
And sometimes I'll be glad that my son's not a sporty. He's a smarty.
My son is a sporty.
Yeah, my son is a smarty.
Yeah, and you know, it's just it's a wake-up call.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, I've never seen that happen before watching football. I mean, I've been watching football as long as I can remember. And I don't recall seeing somebody get hit and just collapse like that. So that was definitely scary, you know what I'm saying? So hopefully our mans will have a recovery, but I'm curious to see, is he going to continue playing in the league, or is he, you know what I'm saying, what direction is he going to go?
I think he needs to go ahead and retire now.
Because, I wouldn't even really want to, just think if you was like the running back, because he was a safety, and you're like, what you going to plow, you going to run him over? You know what I'm saying?
Once you take a hit that bad in that sport, you can't really come back like that. They already take so many brutal and vicious hits that they, when they retire out by 30, 40 years old, they can't even put on their own socks. It looks glorious now, but the end of it is just as bad as being a boxer.
Mm.
It's like shaking
Yeah, like a crushing protocol.
Right. Just like our, you know, that dude wanted to get his brain examined because he did all that stuff, but I'm not going to say his name until we find this young man's name. But it's just crazy. I don't think he should do that if he wanted to expose himself to that. If it was like the little major group, like the little concussions that he usually have, then yeah. But this is a lot. I think he's done with this.
You know, I wonder, Damar Hamlin, by the way. That's his name. Lamar Hamlin. He's in the hospital. I think the name is Mount Sinai. It's Cincinnati. He's still in Cincinnati. That's where they played the game and stuff. But moving forward, so as I'm scrolling through some of this little news stuff, man, you know that the power. I forgot the name. And they plan it and they pull it tonight. I think you have until 11 o'clock, as a matter of fact. We're going to have to shut it down by 10:30, sorry. Go back to the gas station. I forgot. Yeah, we got to play that.
Yeah, we're going to have to go ahead and...
Okay, so you know what? I did. Shout out to Big Germ. Oh, yo, rest up. Shout out to Big Germ. He's been under the weather. That's my boy, man. Y'all don't understand how much my boy this is, man. You know what I'm saying? We grew up a couple doors down from each other. My grandfather and his grandfather were best friends. My grandmother and his grandmother were best friends. You know what I'm saying? And we went to school together. And once I graduated when I was 17, I found an opportunity to go to Cleveland State. And Cleveland State would pay for it. Where I made Jerm come with me. I made him in my dorm room. You know what I'm saying? I told his mother, I asked Jerm, what was he going to do? You know, when about to graduate, he was like, he wasn't going to do nothing. He was just going to stay home with his mother and watch TV. I went and told his mother. You know what his mother said? No, you ain't. You going to get the hell out of my house. Go ahead on. And she was like, give me the paperwork. I'll sign it for him. So I got him to go to Cleveland State with me. You know what I'm saying? Right. And, you know, just life's long. This is my boy, man. And I just wanted to get well. I wanted to get better. You know what I'm saying? So, you know, I'm pushing for you. You know what I'm saying? I'm pushing for you, homie. Also, shout out to my man, G. Wells, supposed to link up with me over the weekend, you know what I'm saying? Greg Wells, you know what I'm talking about?
Are you talking about the same
Cutting Greg Pete.
Wells who used to
Say more. Yeah! My motherfucking dog!
Oh, he used to be the finest thing ever.
Yeah! Cutting Pete, that's my man.
Okay.
Yeah, so yeah, shout out to him,
hey,
you feel
Greg,
me? That's my man. See, check this out. Donovan Mitchell hit with the random PED test. League said 71-point performance shouldn't have happened.
Mm.
So you trying to put a ceiling on a nigga? That just made me want to go hard. That made me want to go hard at everything I know how to do. I hate when people try to tell you what you can't do, man. That's one of the things I can't stand when somebody tries to tell you what you can't do.
Unless it's the doctor.
Well.
But he's still practicing.
Yeah. Yeah, that's something totally different
exactly.
Right there.
He's still practicing. It's just like this with that one, but I don't want that man. I don't want him to play
him. Oh, well, actually, you know, now that she's, I bet you they probably are begging him. Don't you leave this building and then run back, you know what I'm saying? But he, one of the first things that he did do when he started talking again was he asked if he could address his teammates. He wanted to speak to his teammates. So I'm curious to what it is that he did want to tell them. Stand by. By the morning, I bet you you'll know.
I better put a notification in so I get that
money. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, and if I see something, you know I'm going to send it to you.
All the time.
You know I'm going to send it to you.
No,
oh yeah, so back to Big Germ. Big Germ made a mention for me to check out the Best Man series.
Yeah, I've heard from a lot of people now. He's not the only one who said they're getting them checked out.
I watched them all.
You like
that day. Yeah, after when Germ told me that, I went back and I watched it that day, and it was 8 episodes, you know what I'm saying? And plus, I just love Neil. Oh my God.
He didn't watch The Best Man, y'all. He watched Neil Long.
I did. And she is such a boss. I did. Jerm was talking about, oh man, I don't like her in shorts, and I don't like bow legs. And I'm like, what? I'm like, this dude is tripping. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, that girl's beautiful, man. What are you talking about?
He's always been particular.
That's my boy, man. But
he's always been like.
Are you kidding me? The girl's flawless, man.
I'm just saying, for him, he always likes the one that's unexpected. Like, the ones everybody else likes, He's never like that.
I know, because he told us on this show, and we will never forget this.
Oh, my.
You know what he told us?
No. Was it me too here?
No, you weren't here yet.
Okay, so no.
But we will never let him forget this.
Okay, so please.
He said, did you ever see the movie Beloved?
Yes.
With Oprah Winfrey and Danny Glover?
Uh-huh.
Okay. He said, first off, he said Oprah Winfrey was fine in that movie. Now, hold on a second. Because I said, what? So he was like, yeah, she is so fine. I was like, Germ, she had dirt on her feet. And he was like, you know what I'm saying? He was like, she was so fine. So then he said that there was a sex scene when her and Danny Glover were like in one of them little washtub things you stand up. And I'm like, what scene was that? I don't remember that part of the movie. So I'm like, Germ, I think you be making shit up, man. And then you think that. I'm like, nah, that's never. You said she was butt naked? Oprah was never naked in the movie, was she?
Not even gonna entertain that with an answer.
That's my nigga, man.
Oh,
I love Germ, man. That's my boy.
You
man.
Got Bobby's imagination going.
I don't remember that part, bro. I've
never seen Oprah's upper thigh photo.
Nah.
I don't even think I've ever seen Oprah's real cleavage. Like,
I don't remember.
Exactly. Like, you see some club, but
I don't think so.
I don't think so. Germ is imagining.
I don't think so. She hasn't even done like a romantic scene. Did she? I don't think so.
I don't think she's done like a kiss scene.
No.
I think she's done like a tender romantic scene. But not a love.
On what?
Scene. Like, wasn't somebody supposed to be her husband in the movies and they made a hell hands or something? That's as close as I can remember.
Maybe.
Her Harpo. They held
Harpo.
Hands. Okay. Y'all weren't about to give me Black America.
Harpo.
Her Harpo held hands.
Oh my God. Harpo.
I know, definitely
her Harpo hell here. Yo, man, speaking of Harpo, hey, you heard Whitney, you got herself back in trouble. I don't know, man. I'm starting to get to the point where this ain't fun no more. And you can't say nothing.
Who has gotten in trouble?
Whoopi Goldberg.
Again? About what?
The same thing. About, well, here's the thing. Okay, now here's the thing. So I don't think she, the way they put it, The way the media put it is like they're saying that she has not learned anything. Basically, she said something else about like people that be making all of these terms about anti-Semitism, this and that, and the Holocaust type shit. So she said something recently that was like basically saying the same thing she was saying before, but she was saying it like differently though. You know what I'm saying? And they right back at that shit. But I'm like at this point though, bruh, it's people is just too sensitive, man.
But it's okay for them to want to believe in what happened to these people that don't want to erase what happened to us.
Right. Or they'd be like, oh, that was a long time ago.
Right,
oh, stop complaining about it. It didn't happen to you. Like,
I mean, I'm just curious, why is it okay for this but not this? And I'm not going to say it because I don't want nothing coming out or people trying to bash, but it's just crazy the fact that you don't ever want to forget this one thing, but you want to sweep this other thing under the rug. You can't just throw the rock at your hand. You did it both ways. It was done on both sides, and it was bad, and it was wrong. So,
flat out, nigga.
Flat out. Acknowledge where it is.
Don't oh, you know what? Let me say this real quick while I'm thinking, because Bobito, Voice of the Young People, if you're listening, I know you heard about this shit. So I know you got your show. We're going to try to get you together so you can do the Hot Tag Wrestling Corner on Sundays. Everybody in the wrestling, check it out. But the news that I'm going to spoil for you is that Vince McMahon, first off, in the stock market, the WWE, the Wrestling League, mm-hmm. Entertainment Company, their stocks have halted. You can't buy shares in their stocks. Because Vince McMahon said he's coming back to CEO to run WWE again, which means that, all right, like Triple H, I guess, took it over, and Triple H is married to Stephanie McMahon,
yes.
Which is Vince McMahon's daughter.
Yes.
There's some kind of conflict there. There's some kind of conflict. But
she couldn't run it, but he could.
Well, that, but he, the way he says it is that she made it where it's not profitable anymore. And he said that nobody can make it profitable. It has to be him.
It does. Not to be funny, because I'm going to be for real, because I am a geek. Mm-hmm. And even though I may not look like but yes, I've been going to WrestleMania since I believe like WrestleMania.
Have you?
Yeah.
I've only been to one.
Oh my God. We have even, we've been doing them even on pay-per-views since we were kids. You better ask my brother Chili, Donnell. Donnell, you better tell this man. We've been going to WrestleMania. Shout out to Elijah Mary and Monica. You know, the Wells family. They always had us there for WrestleMania. We bring a dish. But even when it was WWF, it was not as profitable when his father was running it as to when Vince took it over. It wasn't. He's just that dude you love to cuss the fuck out. Mm. And I love Vince McMahon. I love him. He's terrible. Mm.
Yep. Well, he's back.
Damn, I wish I wouldn't have known before I could have got me a little $10 share.
Yeah, he's, well, no, it's not going to be frozen for long. It's going to be unfrozen.
Right, but then it's going to be like, because you know once it went down, because he had all that shit
happening. It's going to shift.
It was little.
You could, it's going to skyrocket. Better believe it.
Right.
Damn, I feel like, you know what, man? I love this. It's the weekend. I'm coming down here to these lovely, in the lovely Orion Plaza, right here in the Akon building, downtown Cleveland. You know what I'm saying? I'm going to be here today, tomorrow, Sunday. You know what I'm saying? I'm grinding. I'm firing these turntables up. I finally got my turntables working.
Oh, so we going to get some music?
Yeah. Yep. Goshay coming down. I already hollered at him. Oh, okay. DJ Spud coming down. Shout out. I already hollered at him. I got a couple other guys that's coming down. All year, I'm grinding. I'm finna drop a few mixtapes. We're going to start doing some video packages.
I got that.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, I always
have. I already got the green screen. Go make this shit work. You need to let me know what day. Let me know what day.
All days are available.
I'll let you know when I get, yes, when I go to third shift, and then we'll work it out. We'll work it out.
No, definitely. You know I do it. Everything around the turn fast. Available.
Word.
Available.
Boss. Oh. Yo, I'm just pumped about all of this shit, man. Yeah, I'm definitely doing that, and I'm pumped about, man, if everybody go home and set up my FanDuel, my DraftKings. It's all about these guys right here. Now, I'm not gonna bet with the Cavs yet. Not going to bet with the Indians yet.
It's a, you can't call them that.
Oh, the Guardians.
Yeah.
Damn it.
We're apologizing.
We're
even
apologizing.
Though I have indigenous blood in me, we apologize for saying that.
I forgot all about it.
It's been a long time, people.
Damn. I need. I guess I got a, you know, I got a lot of hats. I got a lot of hats, man. I'm going to have to upgrade my hat collection.
You're going to have to block it out. Cover it a little
bit. Oh, that's the, damn it, man. That's the dopest logo in baseball.
I know chicks who got the big Wahoo on their neck.
Man.
I think a lot.
Man. Why? Yo, so you know today is the anniversary of the insurrection, right?
Oh yeah, when them fools went down there and ain't getting no trouble and they still doing whatever the hell they doing, ain't got fired, nothing, they did nothing. I think they've only got about 2.5 people doing some community service, if that.
Oh no, that's not true.
Oh no, I mean, not hard, but they got what, 6 months?
No.
What did they get?
Oh no. They started bringing the hammer down.
Oh, did they?
Oh, hell
so
yeah.
We really finally complained enough and talked about them enough that they brought the hammer down.
Man, listen, like the last like six people got like big time.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Let me look it up. Let's look up insurrection. I think that's how you just said it, right? Insurrection. And it's actually a topic, I guess. Okay, so January 6th, Capitol rioters arrest and sentences so far. So, it says more than 840 people have been arrested for storming the U.S. Capitol building on January 6th, 2021, with charges ranging from obstruction of an official proceeding to assault. But 17 months after But 17 months after the attempted insurrection, a significant number of rioters are still awaiting their sentencing. Only around a quarter of those arrested, 185 individuals, have received criminal sentences, while the rest are waiting for their trials or haven't yet reached plea agreements. According to the U.S. Attorney's Office for the District of Columbia, 80 defendants were sentenced to periods of incarceration with longer prison terms for those who engaged in violence or threats. So far, the median prison sentence for the January 6th rioters is 45 days. An additional 57 rioters have been sentenced to periods of home detention, while most sentences have included fines, community service, and probation for low-level offenses like illegally parading or demonstrating in the Capitol, which is a misdemeanor. Hundreds of additional cases are expected to be adjudicated in the coming months, with a number of sentencing hearings already in the calendar this fall. Here's a look at what happened to the 14 of the most high-profile January 6th rioters. Robert Scott Palmer got 63 years in prison. No, correction, 63 months, 5 years.
Okay. 5 years is still better than that probation that they was throwing out for the rest of these fuckers.
Delvin Thompson, 46 months in prison. Delvin Thompson took part in the rioting for nearly 3 hours on January 6th, during which time he assaulted a police officer with a metal baton. He also tried to throw a speaker at the police, but missed and ended up injuring another rioter.
And they took him in without incident.
Jackass. And he has to pay, sentenced to 28-year-old Thompson to 46 months in prison with credit for time served, along with 36 months of supervised release and required payment of $2,000 in restitution. Okay, so we'll just go down. Lonnie Leroy Kaufman, 46 months. Nicholas Langeron, 44 months. Jacob Anthony Chansley, 41 months. 41 months, 41 months, 33 months, 28 months, 6 months, 1 month, 18 months, probation. Now you know, there was some our people.
No, if they was our people, we would have all been dead.
Yeah.
And if the
National Guard would have came in there.
And if it would have killed an animal or a dog while they was doing this rioting, they would have all got real time. And that's just what I feel. And I don't care what y'all gotta say. Because it's effed up that they'll sit up here and give these people minor stuff for storming the effing Capitol like dudes. Are you not seeing what I'm seeing? Yeah. But if it would have been us, we would have had under the jail. We would have not got pulled in without restraint, you know, without resistance. There would have been a big ass problem. None of us would have made it to jail unscathed.